Hi, today I will cover how git pull and git push works. Ideally, you want your git is up to date with GitHub. In this example, your git and GitHub has file version 2, which is exactly same. But normally, whenever your team member pushes his update to GitHub, your git now became outdated. And it is your responsibility to maintain your git to be up to date. In this example, your git still has version 2, while GitHub has its version as version 3. This is the situation we will study today. Someone in your team updates one file in GitHub, and you will git pull in order to have up-to-date file first, and update the file, and git push to the GitHub. Let's suppose one team member already pushed his update and the GitHub now has version 3 while your git has version 2, like this diagram. You will comment git pull. After git pull, your git local repository now has version 3 and working directory also have version 3 from your local repository. And let's suppose you updated the file from your Eclipse. Then the file in working directory now updated. And let's call it as version 4 since you have a command git add and git commit. The git local repository still have version 3 until you command git add. After you command git add, your staging area will have version 4, but your git local repository still have version 3. And then, after git commit, now your local repository stores version 4. And then, you command git push. You eventually update the file in GitHub. Now, the GitHub has version 4. Here is the recap. You cannot add without change in working directory. You cannot commit without add. You cannot push without commit. The git pull and git push commands are like this. Remote URL is usually too long to remember, so mostly use origin instead of remote URL. You can check your origin is same with remote URL by command remote-b. Also, in this tutorial, the branch name is master, but you will face to use other branch in real situation, and I will cover what the branch is in the next video. So let's practice. Here's my git, and if you say ls-al, I have the .git folder. That means I have the local repository in this directory. And if I say git pull origin master, as you can see, this is currently up to date. And what is origin? You can say git remote-b. Here, the origin is this remote URL. So if you say just git pull and remote URL, this one, and master, the result should be same. And if you say git branch, you can see my current branch is master branch. That's the reason I say git pull origin master. Here is the branch name. So since my current git local repository is exactly the same with GitHub, let me change something from the GitHub. So here's my GitHub, and let me change here command like updated by other developer and save it. So let's suppose one another developer updated this file, and if I say git pull origin master, now it should have something. So I updated its unique characters.py file, and as you can see, I got the up-to-date its unique characters.py file. So if we open this file, let me open the atom here. And as you can see, update the file by other developer here. So I'm going to update this one, update by myself. And if you say git status, as you can see, my update is in working directory, but I haven't added this one. So working directory has this file. I'm going to add this one, like git add this file, so that I can have this file in my staging area. git add cracking the coding interview. Git add cracking the coding interview .py file. Let me add double quote here. And git status. Now this file is in the staging area, which means I can commit this file now. So git commit minus m is unique k updated by myself. Okay, I committed this file, and now I can say git push origin master. So after I push this one, this one should be changed like this one updated by other developer should be changed like updated by myself. Okay, that's pretty much it. I'll see you on the next video.